Parental discretion is advised.
This show is brought to you by Slice on Broadway, supporting Pittsburgh podcasting with the perfect pepperoni pizza, sliceonbroadway.com. And listeners like you, support this show at patreon.com/wrestlingmayhemshow. Just wait, just wait. Hey guys, it's the Wrestling Mayhem Show, episode 525. So many Tuesdays. Tuesdays. Mike Sorg at Sorgatron on Twitter here in Mayhem Studios. Rocking and rolling, trying to talk some pro wrestling and make sense of who's in trouble now. With me is a bunch of guys that are usually in trouble in their own ways. First of all, the troublemaker himself down in San Antonio, Texas, the voice of Inspire Pro Wrestling, now in a new location, from what I understand. He is Eamon Payton at Eamon to please on the Twitter.
I'm in a new location?
No. Inspire Pro Wrestling has a new location.
Oh, okay. I thought you said I was in a new location.
I might have by accident. I'm
in the same place as always.
I was trying to give you like three different intros, so...
That's fine. Yes, we are in a new location. We'll probably talk about that a bit more in the Mayhem. But yeah.
Yay.
Exciting stuff. I'm excited to talk about the week in wrestling.
Whatever might have happened. And also with us, he is also in Pittsburgh, in the greater Pittsburgh area. He is with Riz Plays Games, the EE Riz, with us right now.
Yes. Just so you know, I am conducting the Mayhem Show pee tests. Just pee in the cup and send it to me. In a self-addressed stamped envelope. Don't ask why.
Wait, what is he sending back?
Never mind.
Also with us from Poughkeepsie, New York, where they know about poo. What is wrong with me tonight? I don't know.
We are all about poo and piss on this week's show.
Sorg, you're not a bad host tonight. You're not a good host tonight. You're just the host tonight.
I've been the host for 10 plus years.
Oh, man. I got my tinfoil hat tonight. We're gonna talk some conspiracy theories. We got Jesse by Ventura on. We got
MacMan.
Cooter from the Beverly Hillbillies movie. No, not Beverly Hillbillies. Dukes of Hazzard. It's all rich tapestry.
And Paul London on line one. Guys, like I said, it's a Wrestling Mayhem Show. We talk wrestling and all the weirdness around it, apparently. WrestlingMayhemShow.com. You can find out so much going on, so many articles, so many different shows that we're doing, as well as reach out to us with that email address.
Good time.
Thank you. Good times at WrestlingMayhemShow.com, 412-206-WMS0. I used you guys to cover up my coughing. I don't know if it was successful.
Cough button, Sorg.
I don't have cough buttons in here yet. We need more Patreons. You can subscribe to us. All the links over at WrestlingMayhemShow.com, audio and video formats, as well as Facebook, as well as YouTube. A lot of great stuff going on there. Thank you so many new people checking out the show over the last few weeks, especially that first round of Mayhem Draft and the Raw wrap up. Hello, everybody, and any new listeners or watchers out there checking us out.
500 people who watched me talk about wrestling.
500 people, 600 people. I was actually reaching 600 people last I checked it.
That video
from last week that was just me for 10 minutes talking about wrestling reached 4,000, I think. I also did make a mistake. I think at some point I said that 20,000 people had watched one of our videos. I meant like 8, actually. Apparently, I kind of screwed
eight
up.
Or 8,000.
Or maybe that one was.
I can believe either.
8,000?
Something absolutely ridiculous. Riz, you're getting a little robot-y. You're getting a little robot-y. You might have to fix that. But we also know the people who support us over at patreon.com/wrestlingmayhemshow. So shouts out to, of course, the eldest Patreon supporter, Antonio Garza of thewrestlingrevolution.com, as well as the Matthew and Jennifer Carlin's Foundation for Podcast Betterment, Ed Burke, Alexander Cars of Power to the Smarks, and Occupy Pro Wrestling. And was that everybody? That's everybody, right? I think that's everybody.
That's everybody, Torg.
That's like five different things. That's right. You can do so as well.
Do I sound less robotic?
No, you're more robotic.
No,
Patreon.com/WrestlingMayhemShow or just share it. It's okay if you don't toss us a couple bucks, although we do appreciate that too. Share the show, rate the show, tell a friend about the show, comment on the show, like the page, like the videos that we post. Even if you don't watch them, that's okay. We won't tell anybody. Mark Zuckerberg knows anyways. Have some fun with us. What's that? You should watch them. Put them on the background on your phone while you're washing dishes and whatever. The sweet sounds of Mad Mike yelling midweek war will just soothe you into a concussion.
We talked a lot about that 70s show last week.
Yes, they did. By the way, I was skipping through, and I have determined the Midweek War will never need a theme song as long as Mad Mike starts the show.
As long as I can still impersonate Vince McMahon horribly, we will never need a theme song.
Indeed. And if you're ever out, we'll just get Krista Joseph to do it for you as our celebrity fill-in.
Fair enough. El Hijo del Cueto would be more than thrilled to do that.
Ha ha! All right, guys, let's get into the stories of the week. What happened? Hey, wait a minute. Hey, what happened? What did you do?
Is that Roman built on extra thick 2-ply paper, because he looks a little puffy. Sorg.
Can I title this segment?
Okay.
The title of this week's segment is, I'm not a bad guy. I'm not a good guy. I just know a guy.
That's good, Eamon.
I just want to get that out there. I
thought you were going to go, they weren't good drugs, they weren't bad drugs, they were just the drugs, but yours is way better, Eamon. Yours is way better. Wrestling Mayhem Show, I know a guy.
So, what happened? What happened, guys? I got the notification while I was talking with somebody about some video up the coffee shop, and I'm like, that's a kayfabe article, right? That's kayfabe news, right? Is that what's happening right now? And I go, and everybody's freaking out on the internet over this thing. What happened? Do we know anything other than the announcement that he's been suspended for 30 days, and that was as of today?
That's really all we know.
Yeah. I think this happened a while ago.
There's speculation that they knew for a few days.
Oh, I think they probably knew for longer than that.
I really think they do.
All right. And this is where I put on my tinfoil hat, because when I first saw this, I said it was a work, which, I mean, it's not a work. It's obviously not a work.
You don't make a work out of the very serious.
Timing is suspicious.
Yes, very much.
Timing is suspicious because, Roman just happened to lose the title. Oh, they just happened to book a Shield triple threat at a pay-per-view that's not SummerSlam.
I think the thing that kind of like just makes it feel like it's not a work is just from the fact that technically he can still be at Battleground.
Yes,
right. 30-day suspension doesn't go through Battleground.
You can't tell me that wasn't the plan. I don't know that there's anything that specifies, hey, you just failed the wellness policy. We're gonna have you suspend as of Tuesday after we do some cleanup. Right.
Right.
I don't think this has happened, and I don't think this will happen, and I could be wrong. Somebody correct me if this happened. Has anybody failed a wellness test and then not been able to be in that evening's pay-per-view? I don't think they're going to do that if they don't have to. And considering the wellness policy is self-imposed,
it's self-imposed to a degree. They still have stockholders.
Well, of course, but I think I think they're within their own rights to do this the way that they do it. I think they're, you know.
Well, think also, like, he can't, 30 isn't to, at least to my knowledge, isn't just you can't wrestle in these 30 days. It's that you can't, like, he can't, like, do, like, a segment on the show.
Yeah, right. No, he can't show up there at all. He's suspended.
And I think he's not getting paid for 30 days.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
But, you know, I don't think we're getting the triple threat at Battleground. I don't.
I think they're going to address it next week on Raw, because SmackDown's already been recorded or will be as of tonight. Hell, they could even announce it tonight and address it.
Yeah, because technically they announced it before the taping started.
And they could use it as a tool to make Seth more of a heel. Mm-hmm. I think they absolutely could. Like Seth could even say, "I even jacked up. He couldn't beat me." That's my horrible Seth Rollins. But I think we're going to get it's really, really convenient that Roman is not going to be around for the 30 days that they would have been promoting a match where he would have been booed heavily against the two other people in the match.
Yeah, I mean, it's convenient, but I don't know. I think I'm not to, you know, stomp on your tinfoil hat, so to speak, but there's no way that this is any form of a work.
Yeah.
I don't see them going up to Roman being like, "Hey, we booked you. We want to do this triple threat at SummerSlam, but we got to do something between Battleground. We're going to basically take you off TV for that month." And theoretically, his response should be like, "Oh, like somebody's gonna like attack me and maybe injure me and like put me on the shelf. We're gonna do a story like that." No, we're gonna make it act like you violated our wellness policy. Roman's response should be like, "No."
Yeah.
Because here's the thing, it still hurts Roman's reputation.
Right, right. Especially, well, go ahead and Riz, and I have some thoughts on this.
Saying that the timing has everything to do with it is, I don't see it, because they had to sum up something. They had to sum up last week, because it was the build up to Battleground, and it was the first week to Battleground. So they had to make sure that everything was copacetic with what happened yesterday or on Money in the Bank. So I don't think it would be more just going, "Okay, you're suspended for this long." Mm-hmm. But I do see everybody's point, because I caught everybody's in between, because I was trying to fix my whole wonky system here. But it just seems weird that in 30 days he's still going to be main eventing a pay-per-view.
Mm-hmm. I don't think
you think he's going to be off the pay-per-view?
Yes, definitively. I think he is. I think you're going to have Shane and Stephanie come out as a united front and say, "Hey, listen, Roman Reigns is suspended. He is out of the match at Battleground."
Because
doesn't mean he can't appear at Battleground,
right,
and attack both of them.
Yeah, because you can't really explain that off of like,
no, you can't.
They can't go on TV like in a story and say he's suspended, but he's still going to be in the match.
Mm-hmm. Like, yeah, I was going to say you can't really say he's suspended, have him still come out during the match, and expect him to be a face.
Yeah, yeah. And I think they're going to use like, and you know who it's perfect for to announce this? Stephanie. Stephanie can, because she'll be the heel, because she'll be the one saying that Roman isn't in the match.
Well,
Shane didn't have her authority to even make him a part of the match in the first place. So they don't even have to talk about the suspension. Mm-hmm. They can just say, "Listen, Roman Reigns lost to Seth Rollins. Seth Rollins gets a rematch. Shane did not have my authority to do that."
I think there's ways around it. Sorg, you were going to say something?
Well, I thought this was interesting because, I think Roman does the right thing here, and I think Titus reflected this as well when he was suspended a few months ago, where his comment was, you know, "Hey, I did it. I'm going to own up for it. I'm sorry to my friends and family that I've disappointed." You know, that's a classy way. That's
totally different.
That's not in context of your conversation. I'm just saying this is part of a bigger point. So one, handle a lot better than guys like Adam Rose, and that's why this guy is not going to be disappeared and conveniently resigned.
That's also kind of iffy there, sort of.
But in the meantime, I've always said for years, we also don't know what he got caught for too. I've said for years, if John Cena ever got caught with the wellness violation, he would be destroyed. Because he's a guy who is very adamantly says that he's natural, et cetera, et cetera. And you know, if that's the case.
Well, it depends on what he got caught for. Like, if he got busted for weed, he'd be fine.
He'd be a new hero to a lot of us.
Basically. I mean, and let's not mince words. Snoop Dogg basically said that at the Hall of Fame.
That's true, too. There you go. There you go.
He kind of did. I mean,
I'm wondering if they're altering their policy on weed at this point, but who knows?
Randy Orton's happy about that.
Somebody give me a hand. Rob Van Dam will be back any day now. But I wonder if that does anything to his reputation, because obviously he's, at least in our view, like he's a squeaky clean, good guy face, you know, that gets the same divisive reaction that John Cena does for being squeaky clean.
I think he's done.
He's done? You think they give up on him that hard after this?
You know why?
This is the end of the Roman Reigns experiment?
Do you know why I'm saying this?
Why are you saying this, Riz?
Parents.
Parents?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay. Parents.
Parents?
They are buying the tickets for their kids to see Roman Reigns.
Are your parents mad?
They're buying the Roman Reigns t-shirts. They're buying the Roman Reigns... They're buying into Roman Reigns, and he is main eventing a pay-per-view, and then he gets caught with something. And again, we don't know what.
I think it depends on this something.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, but it really depends on what you got busted with.
Cocaine.
To most parents, they see that a wrestler is getting suspended that their kid likes. They're going to be very, very upset.
They'll be upset for a little bit, and then when he comes back and apologizes, they'll be fine.
Well, thing is, I can't think of somebody. When was the last time somebody got busted who was on that level?
Randy Orton.
Well, Randy Orton.
Rey Mysterio.
But who was directly in that title picture?
Rey Mysterio.
Did he get busted when he was in the title picture?
Yeah, I believe so. Yeah.
No. He got hurt, and then he got caught.
Right, then he got busted.
I was going to say,
the closest one I could think of, and technically I guess it's on a lesser level, but still, was Rob Van Dam when he got
caught. Yeah, but he got caught for something completely different.
Yeah, yeah.
We think. We assume, anyway.
Yeah.
And besides, that's when the weed was punishable by suspension.
Right.
Yeah. Yes. I don't believe it is now. I believe it's just a fine.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So
I have a thought about this. About what they can do with Roman Reigns afterwards. Let's say I'm wrong and they do have the match at Battleground and Roman Reigns just gets nerfed, like just gets completely destroyed. If you're looking ahead to SummerSlam, you know who else has been in the media about drug tests a lot lately? Brock Lesnar! You do a rematch with Reigns and Lesnar, and you could have Heyman just do a work shoot, brother, and that would be a killer match.
I was going to say, my suggestion would just be to give Roman Reigns Darren Young's gimmick and have Bob Backlund yell at him about the morality of drugs.
We're going to make Roman Reigns great again.
I just want to see Roman Reigns and Bob Backlund interact. That's all I care about.
Wow.
By the way, this is a complete sidebar, but about those Backlund, Darren Young things. Has anyone noticed that their backgrounds are Raw and SmackDown?
Yes.
I thought it was just because it was like red, white, and blue.
Those are also the colors of America.
Yes.
America.
Yeah. I mean, that's what I was going with. I think, guys.
I just think it'd be really funny, like if one of them was drafted to Raw,
How they're in. They make it seem like they're in two different arenas. Like it's like. Like you know, there's just like Bob's standing out like in another, like just staring at him, and then he's staring back, and there's two cameras pointed outwards.
But also, why can't you show them interacting? Like, what makes that?
Because this is so much better.
This is the style. This is the style they selected, and they're committed to it. Also, they probably filmed the entire thing in a day, and they're stretching it out over 3 months. I want to point that out. So sorry, Mike.
I want them to pan out once from Bob Backlund's shot, and you just see the shining stars ready to do their promo right next to him. He's like, is this guy almost done yet? Who is he yelling to? There's no one else here.
Darren Young is a figment of our imagination. So I think we need to address the real issue that Tragar brings up in the chat room. that the whole thing was done to smokescreen Paige being sent in for a mental screening. Now, I haven't seen anything to confirm this mental screening, but I saw I think someone saw a story about Paige was seen in handcuffs being led to an ambulance after Money in the Bank in Las Vegas Sunday night, and there was speculation that it might have been something for Total Divas or Swerved or something like that. But
they said there were the later report said that there were no cameras.
No cameras. That. Okay. You never know, hidden cameras, whatever, right? But apparently...
So many people get dragged into ambulances in Vegas, it's, you know...
Then yeah. Why then why give her a title shot
The
next night? If she was that bad, why give a title shot?
Well, apparently not. There's no charges. No charges anybody found. She might have been in a hospital, perhaps. I haven't seen anything confirming anything about her mental state or anything like that. That you know, obviously not bad enough that she got pulled off, but supposedly WWE is investigating whatever the incident was. So there you go. Perhaps an altercation involving Alberto Del Rio is one report here. This is on Forbes. I don't know.
I think that's just internet bullshit. Yeah. It's probably just something involving a fan, like with what happened with Jericho.
Well, because some of those photos, they just assume that because some of the photos show both her and Del Rio, like talking to like one of the officers or whatever or something like that.
You never know. It could be anything. So. Well, it's interesting. Let's.
They were supposed to last forever.
How did that relationship not last, guys?
Love is dead, y'all.
22-year-old English woman with a like 30-plus-year-old Mexican
man. And that lasted how long? Like a month.
She's only as old as her mother.
What?
Oh, that's true.
What? No.
What?
Alberto Del Rio is as old as.
Oh, Paige's I was gonna mother. Say.
He's as old as her mother.
I thought you said she is. I'm like, that's not how science.
Oh, sorry, I misspoke. Yeah, no, but he's as old as Paige's mother.
Wow.
Oh God, that's even
mother. That doesn't work.
Well,
so is Jerry Lawler, and he's kind of.
Oh, we should talk about Jerry Lawler.
Continuing wrestlers behaving bad. Jerry Lawler apparently getting a domestic spat with his wife. 27-year-old
wife.
Fiance.
Can we fire him now?
He's suspended. So there you go.
I'll be honest. Jerry, hi, it's Mad Mike here. Hi, how you doing, buddy? I don't know if you get podcasts in prison. If you do,
it's probably podcast.
I have an idea for you. Go to Florida. No, not the performance area. You stay the fuck away from there.
Go to TNA.
Yes. Go to TNA, please. You're kind of shaky on how you feel about African-Americans, as it is. If you can take the Pope's job, I'd very much appreciate that.
I really
would. No, you know how we announce names?
Nothing against the Pope, but that would be an
upgrade. Your buddy Al Snow's there. You love Al Snow. He's blowing a whistle like Fonzie. It's going to be great. You're going to love it there.
Wait,
and
is he?
Plus, your girlfriend or fiance gets to ride the teeter totters for free. I mean, come on. It's freaking win.
There you go.
Just stay away from the pond.
On that note, guys, hey, I want to give a shout out. We'll talk some more money in the bank and everything else. What?
No, let's not get past that. Riz, what did you just say?
I just said stay away from the pond.
You realize that they're different plates.
Yes.
Yes, I do.
Okay.
Continue on, Sorg, with your commercial about pizza.
Pizza.
Oh, Sorg, it's 9 o'clock. Impact is actually on.
Yay. There you go, live reports.
It is actually on, and fuck, this is horrible looking.
Oh, you know,
stay tuned for the midweek war next week.
Horrible looking?
Slice on Broadway.
So yes. On Broadway.
I was going to say breaking news. TNA just got busted for the WWE Wellness Policy.
Well, they were a hot topic last night. We'll maybe talk about that too. Slice on Broadway. Check them out. The friends of the show supporting Pittsburgh podcasting with the perfect pepperoni pizza right here in Beachview, Carnegie, PA, down on Main Street, and PNC Park, the home of the Pittsburgh Pirates. Thank you, Pop Filter. They've been supporting the show for a while and feeding our guests and in studio co-hosts for the shows here on Tuesday night. This isn't the only show that we do on Tuesdays, of course. We do, you know, something called the Awesome Cast, something called the Indie Mayhem Show, and we have a good podcasty time here every Tuesday night on Podcast Day, and it is fueled by pepperoni and pizza and Slice on Broadway. Check them out, sliceonbroadway.com, PGH_Slice on the tweeters. And Slice on Broadway on Instagram and Facebook. And let them know the Mayhem Show sent you. All right, guys. Money in the bank. The Shield is, well, they were in charge. I was very excited to see Money in the Bank. I ended up watching it finally finished at like 3:30 in the morning. So a little bit of delay there. What? Not much lately, actually. And that streak is going to continue. But anyways, the Shield, I love that the Shield have each held the WWE title in one night.
That's amazing.
In one night. Like, these are the future, these are the now, and it's great to see that ride that has happened. And the circle kind of closed with Dean Ambrose. Raw, I thought, followed up Money in the Bank with a lot of energy. We talked about Riz and I on the Raw wrap-up last night. You can find it at Wrestling Mayhem Show and all of our outlets. There's a lot of meaning to a lot of the segments, except for like Zack Ryder and Baron Corbin, for instance, right? So I think they're on a good streak. What were you guys' general thoughts of Money in the Bank and maybe even that follow-up Raw?
I thought the show was built around three matches, and two of them delivered.
Okay.
The Cena AJ Styles match, I thought it was great, but they did the laziest finish they could do. The absolute laziest finish.
Mm-hmm. I thought he had a smart finish. I thought the ref bump looked lame.
they saved it a little bit on Raw for me. Like when Gallows and Anderson came out and said that they didn't sign that contract, I'm like, okay, that's kind of clever. Because it makes sense. But, I mean, you had Kevin Owens beat John Cena clean. Why couldn't you just do it with AJ?
Because AJ's a heel.
Kevin Owens is a heel. It was Kevin Owens.
But what I mean is, they're just reaffirming that whole AJ's a heel thing. I don't think there's wrong with a heel winning dastardly.
No, and
but
even
in, when you do the same thing two matches later.
What do you mean?
With Roman and Dean. They did another ref bump and another, like...
Yeah, that was stupid. Like, I agree. But I like the... Here's the thing. I like the AJ Cena match more than I liked... I thought Roman and Seth was kind of lame for the most part.
Like, it was too long.
It was too long. Roman got, to me, a lot of offense in. And, like, I don't know. It was just kind of slow a little bit, it felt, until, like, the end.
I did like that Seth actually got a clean win over Roman, though. I thought that was great.
I thought that was good. I think that works for Seth, though. I think that works for Seth's story. Mm-hmm. You know, I like the story that I like the story they're telling with AJ, in that John Cena kind of telling him, "Can you do this on your own? Because you haven't been successful the last two times against Roman Reigns. You weren't successful at WrestleMania. Like, you know, can you do this on your own?" And the whole doubt in AJ's mind being, you know, but he's bringing his air of confidence to himself, but being like, I don't think I can do this on my own. I think that's great. That's the story that worked for Seth his whole title.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, but this isn't for a title. And
so,
unless AJ wins another match, which I don't think he's going to, then it makes AJ look horrible.
I think he has a better chance to than Owens.
Yeah.
How does it look now? I worry. So, Mike, I'm worried that you're just like, well, this is going to suck because they're obviously going to make it suck. You know, like I feel like your expectations are already set on this one.
No, how my expectations are judged based on the history of John Cena with these guys.
Right.
Well, I understand that. Rusev, Owens, even Sheamus at that point. Like, the first guy gets one win over John Cena and then loses for the rest of time.
Mm-hmm.
Like, Bray Wyatt still hasn't recovered. Rusev has barely recovered. Kevin Owens is fine, but that's because Kevin Owens is a unicorn in a sea of horses.
My thing is, I think I agree with you completely, and I do think based off history is something, you know, you should take into account. However, I would argue AJ probably has the best chance out of all those people from the fact that he was three or four months into his time in WWE, he was being given main event world heavyweight title matches on pay-per-view.
But Heyman, he hasn't won a big match.
But that's not – it's not the –
He beat John Cena.
He beat John Cena.
Yeah, Bray Wyatt did too.
You can't.
But you have to get my point. They are clearly extending this feud. I think they'll extend it till SummerSlam. And the Owens feud didn't extend till SummerSlam. It extended until like Battleground.
Well, that's because the Seth Rollins thing happened.
Right. But then there was
Elimination Chamber in between. That's why.
Right. And then Rusev was only to Extreme Rules. Think of the fact – I think at least of the fact of this is SummerSlam, and if you're building John Cena, AJ Styles, big for SummerSlam, that's the perfect opportunity to give AJ Styles that big win.
And they won't. I agree with you. Giving AJ Styles that big win in SummerSlam would be amazing. They're not going to do that.
I'm stepping in here. Here's the thing I don't like, and this is not against you guys. This is against a lot of fans out there. They see and they look at history and they go, they're not going to do this again. They're going to do this again. They're going to do this again. They're going to do this again. And it doesn't matter what happens in that ring. It could happen and it could not happen. But you just have this mindset of it's going to happen, so it's going to suck. So I say live in the moment. Find that match that you like and love it. Like, I don't care that this probably happened before. AJ Styles versus John Cena is going to be an amazing match. It's going to be an amazing series. It's going to be amazing. So let it happen.
That's the point. Yeah. Are you watching wrestling? Are you watching wrestling for the experience, for the ride, or for the result?
Does this make a mess right now?
No,
sure. I love wrestling.
No, Sorg, I'm in it for both.
Okay.
Because literally we are in a time where you can find a good wrestling match on any show you watch.
Yeah.
Any show.
TNA. Like,
no, you can find a good wrestling match on TNA. You'll have to look a little bit harder, but you can find one.
Mm-hmm.
But you have to have a good story built around it. And if the end is just, lol, John Cena wins, that's not a good story. That is the same story we've seen every single time. It's what has hindered John Cena's entire character arc. He's never had to deal with loss because he always gets rematches until he wins.
But we had the Year of Sorrow with John Cena. Nobody remembers that.
The Year of Sorrow, he won the WWE title, Sorg.
Here's the thing. Yes, I agree.
Yes, because it took him a year to bring it. He had a bad year, and that was the greatest story.
It was such a sorrow year.
He legitimately got divorced to sell it.
Yes, John Cena doesn't lose a lot, and yes, that has created this character about him. But it also in turn makes this thing where if John Cena loses, it is a big deal. If it's done right, I understand Kevin lost him two times after and all that stuff. But when you beat John Cena, it's still a big deal. It's the same thing as, like, say, if you beat Brock Lesnar, it's a big fucking deal because Brock is built up to such a degree.
Brock only wrestles once every couple months. Yeah. If John Cena did that too, I'd be totally fine with it. But John Cena wrestles and wins every fucking week.
But also, it's much more probable that somebody's going to beat John Cena than somebody's going to beat Brock Lesnar.
I don't think that's true.
Name someone who can beat Brock Lesnar on the main roster. Name someone.
Seth Rollins.
Sami Zayn.
Really?
Yes. What? Absolutely. Seth Rollins could. I think if they had been done properly, Dean Ambrose could have too, and so could have Roman.
You're saying if he could be done properly. Like, if it, of what people are built to right now.
Yeah. Kevin Owens, all three members of the Shield. And together. No, all three members of the Shield. Shinsuke Nakamura.
If all three members of the Shield could beat Brock Lesnar, then any of them would have. Mm-hmm. They've all had matches with Brock, and none of them beat them.
Technically, Seth did.
But technically.
In a triple threat match, he did.
And you're saying, and pinned
Roman Reigns.
He's right.
Yep. Technically, Kevin Owens has beaten John Cena. And technically, AJ Styles has beaten John Cena.
Yes, but I think it's more of a legitimate chance because Brock Lesnar he's not Superman. He's just a monster. John Cena literally recovers from everything. Like that's the issue. Like even if you beat John Cena clean as a sheet, he will always get that rematch back. If you beat Brock Lesnar once, you won't see Brock again for 3 months. And you'll forget Brock had that loss.
But again, when
is Brock? Because you know who also beat Brock Lesnar? John fucking Cena.
Right, because that makes sense. I'm saying, because that makes sense. John Cena and Triple H have beaten Brock Lesnar.
Cesaro could beat Brock. That's a good point. Good point for Matt.
That's a good point.
As constituted now, I don't think Cesaro could.
Ooh. Right, because he's now built up to a certain way. Yeah. John Cena, you have a better chance of getting a big win over and using the fact that he is so undefeatable as a tool. Beating John Cena, that's why any big match with John Cena is sold as like a big main event match, is because it's almost like it's basically almost like Taker at Mania. Like, it's almost treated in that same regard.
All right, guys. I want to wrap up this portion of the discussion because it will continue. Because just like Sami Zayn and Kevin Owens will fight forever, we will talk about John Cena in this regard forever. And by the way, I need to catch up with some comments from the chat room. First of all, I believe this is Matt Carlins is hanging out in there. Mayhem Show, at its core, is an endless debate on John Cena, and there's nothing wrong with that.
We miss Will. We miss Lunchbox.
Yeah.
This is pretty much us pleading to Lunchbox.
You know what? By the way, side note from that, I thought about that. When I saw the news about Roman Reigns, I realized something. In the grand scheme of the fandom.
Holy shit, he was right.
He won. He won. He won.
Because remember what he said. Remember what Lunchbox said. He said that every fan base has lost something except for one, and that's John Cena's fan base,
except for that year of sorrow,
and he wound up winning.
Rise above hate,
the wellness policy,
rise above predictable booking,
rising above Samoa. Also from the chat room, Juggalo John chimed into the question we had thrown out. I put out on Twitter, you know, do we watch wrestling about the result or the ride that it takes us on? The question I posed to you, Mike. Juggalo John actually responds, I used to only watch WCW's first hour for the mid-card because it was an amazingly fun matches to watch no matter who won. There you go. So there's one take on it.
Hot take.
Also, I don't know where this came from, but WMS XXX, a unicorn in a sea of horses.
That's how I describe Kevin Owens.
Oh, okay. Okay.
And we don't know. We actually don't know what number we're on.
Guys, if you want to see fun wrestling and maybe don't care about the result, except for maybe the result of Super Indie coming very soon, digital download on there. It's indiewrestling.us. There's a lot of great stuff, including some great stuff featuring certain dude that was on American Ninja Warrior, Zach Gowen. You can check out Handicap Heroes, him and Gregory Iron, who was in the crowd for American Ninja Warrior from the Prime Wrestling Prime Cuts collection over there on andywrestling.us, and of course the documentary about Zach Gowen, including some matches from his first match, I believe, is on there, commentated by himself, and I think Truth Martinez on commentary with that as well, hot fact, recorded around Truth Martinez's coffee table. That was an interesting experience.
Stream stopped.
Well, okay, that's great. We're still recording.
Keep going.
All right. Keep going. All right.
Keep going, sorry.
Not so important there, Riz, and we're going to a break anyways. IndieWrestling.us, finding Zach Gowen, and a lot of other great, great stuff over there. Sign up for the newsletter. You'll get updates on Wrestling Mayhem Show and sales and new titles coming out all the time over there. IndieWrestling.us. IndieWrestling.us. What's that address, Riz?
IndieWrestling.us.
There you go. We'll be right back after this with the big question and, of course, the Mayhem Draft.
Hey everyone, this is Showtime Eric Young from TNA, all nonstop wrestling on Spike TV. You're listening to the Wrestling Mayhem Radio Show.
Wrestling Mayhem Show. The crew has altered, getting ready for the round, the third round of the Mayhem Draft. Although I realize we let Eamon go, and he's kind of the proprietor of the rules, so we should probably bring him back in a moment. So can somebody invite him back in? It's time for the big question. And this week, I was a little late watching the pay-per-view, and I was like, should I put the kickoff on? I don't know. And I flipped through it, and I'm using the 10-second skip to just kind of slam through this thing and see how the matches turned out, see what they did on it, which I was really pleasantly surprised to see how much tag team wrestling was on the kickoff show. I was very happy with that. But one of the things that, and I just learned a little bit more about that, one of the big things was this Golden Truth versus Fandango and Tyler Breeze sunburn angle that happened, which is completely new to me. I'm being told by at the break that this is something that has been developing on the Raw pre-show, apparently. That I've been avoiding for months.
I was going to say, Sorg, we didn't come up with this.
No.
We're going to say the Raw wrap-up show. And
No. We have all other angles going on there. But a fantastic low-card angle that was very entertaining. So the big question of the week is, what is a low-to-mid-card kind of angle that's one of your favorites of all time? Who would like to tackle that first of the crew? Riz, still with us. What do you think?
Let me just go on by saying, number one, arm drag. Number two, arm bar. Number three, the moss-covered three-handed family grandunzel. Number four, arm bar. You know the rest. Come on. He listed 1,004 holds in order on a Nitro. And Jericho just doing that the entire night, and just the feud that he had with Dean Malenko in the process.
Stinko Malenko.
Yes. Made it worthwhile. And there is a paste bin that lists all 1,004 holds, which feature 142 arm bars. I don't know how accurate this is, but I love just like number 300 is the open hand chop. Number 301 is the double chest chop.
Is number 302 the knife edge chop?
No, it is the bulldog lariat.
God damn it. You know, you'd think they'd separate into.
That is a good answer, though.
Thank you.
But wrong. I believe there was one that said, like, let me see if I can find it. It was the right hand punch, and then probably 10 or 15 numbers down was the left hand punch. But yeah, just that moment solidified his place in Jarrett-troll stardom. Moving on, sir.
Okay.
Moving on. Who's next?
Mr. Sorosine.
All right. I have one. And this wasn't more of a continuing storyline, but D'Lo Brown's chest protector.
Mm-hmm.
When D'Lo Brown was the European champion, and I would argue the greatest European champion, the rumor in the back is that someone deemed that D'Lo Brown was a little, shall we say, pudgy. So, in order to cover up that pudginess, he had a fake pectoral injury and had to wear a chest protector for the majority of his WWE career.
Mm-hmm.
And this chest protector was a loaded chest protector.
Allegedly.
Allegedly. Excuse me.
It was never proven.
And now, how this loaded chest protector didn't hurt D'Lo more than it did his opponents when he did a lowdown, I'm not going to speculate on that, but just I don't even remember who he was wrestling. I want to say it was like X-Pac.
It's probably Val Venus.
It might have been Val. Oh no, it was Val Venus because he used the money shot. You're right. But Val Venus had knocked out D'Lo Brown at one point and removed the chest protector and put it on himself and did a money shot to win.
Oh, the Oh yeah, that was right. I think yeah. I watched that once on.
Yeah, I just loved, like, because D'Lo Brown was one of the most entertaining parts of the Nation to me. Because he was like the hanger-on. He was like the road dog. He was the guy that was in the background. You always knew he was doing something, but he was never going to be the main focus of it. But just – I love the chest protector. I love a good gimmick like that, like Bob Orton's cast, Owen Hart's slammy. Like, you know, just anything like that. It's so, so great. I love it.
Like, he's like – oh. Rick Martel's arrogance.
Yes.
Oh, absolutely. That was a good one. That yep. was one. So yep. we might be taking other people's. We might be taking other people's. With us,
sorry.
Mainstream Matt is with us. Matt Carlins, do you have one?
Greg the Hammer Valentine's shin guard.
Oh,
the heartbreaker.
Yeah. You know what's funny is that Riz, I think Riz kind of stole mine because I was thinking of back in the glory days of Chris Jericho and Dean Malenko. When Chris Jericho managed to forcibly force Dean Malenko out of wrestling, publicly shamed him, shamed his father, shamed the entire Malenko family. And then that led to, on pay-per-view, a wonderful cruiserweight battle royal in which Chris Jericho did ring introductions for every single cruiserweight, which was hilarious in itself. Mm-hmm, in and of itself. Mm-hmm. And the end of the battle royal came, and it was down to Ciclope and Juventud Guerrera. And Ruby took a kind of look crossways, look at Ciclope, and kind of nodded his head and threw himself over the top rope. And people were like, "What's this?" And Jericho got into the ring, and Ciclope unmasked, and holy moly, it was Dean Malenko, hot baby face, House of Fire, and he beat the Chris Jericho from pillar to post.
It was so awesome. And then didn't, like, at the end, like, I think the night after that, didn't Jericho go to, like, the, what was that, the Library of Congress
or something? Oh, yeah, like that? Yeah, that's when
that might have led to the Chris Jericho Goes to Washington skits. Yeah, yeah. You're right. Man, that was just an inspired run, that whole stretch there for Jericho. He was on fire.
Yeah, I mean, and then,
pretty sure that's the moment when all of us kind of fell in love with Jericho.
And if it wasn't then... It was his feud with Goldberg, and he brought Ralphus into the creation.
And
the Jericho personal security.
And don't forget the Jericho personal ninja that they had.
Of course, yeah, naturally.
All right.
No, Sorg, don't look at me like that.
Anyways, also with us, joined us here on the break, is...
Speaking of personal ninjas...
Oh, my own personal ninjas. He is, of course, Hot Wheels... of the Renegade Wrestling Alliance. The sound guy over there joins us. Yes.
What's up, everybody? Well, if we're going to go for cool little devices like the Heartbreaker, the chest pad, I'm going to go for, I'm surprised nobody said it, Mike Sharp's wrist protector. It, I swear to God, was always loaded, and they always thought it was loaded.
Nice.
Cool.
Excellent.
Cool.
That's better than mid card angle. That's like
yeah. I was gonna say that was
preliminary card angle. That's great.
Yeah.
Thank you.
I'm sure you have a fondness for SD Jones while you're at it too.
And also the narcissist Lex Luger.
Yeah, I almost
loaded forearm pad, baby.
Oh, you know what? Oh.
Uh oh.
Mr. Wonderful.
Yeah. Just in general.
just as a whole. So for me,
didn't he call a psychic in WCW?
Yeah, he did.
Because
yes.
he stopped pretending. He stopped thinking that he was wonderful.
Mm-hmm. He called a psychic friend.
Yeah.
Shit. What was his name?
Somebody search for that on Wrestle Crap.
White puffy hairdo.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. I'm looking at it.
Go research that and come back here. But I'll say mine while we're at it. I was reminded of this, and it was one of my favorite things. Mamacita.
Yes.
China Sork, and Eddie Guerrero.
Yes.
Was the greatest stuff. They went to prom, guys.
They went to prom the night of a pay-per-view.
Yes, they did. Like, that was their pay-per-view angle, was they went to prom.
No one holds Sunday night prom.
Yeah, who has prom on a Sunday?
Wasn't it like a community college? I'm like, community colleges don't have proms.
That's all right. That's all right. But no, that was definitely my favorite. Did you
almost,
get that name, Riz?
Anything Eddie Guerrero did before he won the title was amazing.
Yes.
Shit, I just saw it.
Like the Los Guerreros with the
Gary Spivey. Like,
Gary Spivey, wow. Wow. Well,
By the way, speaking of lower card things, Sorg, I made a purchase for a San Diego Comic-Con exclusive wrestling figure of a lower card angle. And that is the Shockmaster figure.
Oh, my.
I'm going to have the Shockmaster figure in my possession in a month.
You do not take that out of...
I know. No.
We don't play with this one. Nope.
But it's amazing. The figure comes packaged upside down, and the Stormtrooper helmet is separate because it's already fallen off his head. I can't wait to have this fucking thing in my hand, Sork.
Wow. Wow. All right. On that note, let us know what you think. Big question. What's your favorite mid-card angle from the years past? So check us out at Mayhem Show on Twitter and also on the Facebook page or wherever you want to get at us.
From Bobby in the chat.
Oh, yeah.
We have Cody's clear mask when he was dashing Cody Rhodes or Moppy.
Moppy. What about Pepe?
Oh, all right. No lie. The first time I ever cried in professional wrestling was when Eddie put Pepe in the wood chipper. No lie. The first time.
Was it Eddie? I thought it was Norman Smiley.
Was it Norman? I thought it was Eddie. Because he wanted Chavo to be serious.
Heyman might be right.
Okay, yeah, it might be. Whoever it was that did it, I just looked at them like they were a monster.
And real quick, so we brought Eamon back in to conduct the draft here in a moment. Do you have one you want to submit for the big question?
I think you guys took a lot. Moppy was going to be one of mine. I've fond memories of Moppy.
Awesome. Well, so it's time for the Mayhem draft. It is round three. Eamon, give us an update. What's going on? What's going on with the draft?
Okay, so if you've listened to past episodes, you know the rules. We're drafting 10 guys each week. Team Raw, the Team SmackDown, Team Raw. Games, of course, the one known Silvertron, along with Dudders, Wheels, Alex Cars, and Riz. Team SmackDown is myself, Mad Mike, Bobby F. J-Town, Matt Carlins, Antonio Garza. Like I said, we each draft 10 people each week. And I'll run through the card. I'll run through the talents drafted so far. This will be our third round of play, so everyone has 20 right now. So far, representing Team Raw, we have Seth Rollins, Finn Balor, Kofi Kingston, Bray Wyatt, Dean Ambrose, Big E, AJ Styles, Cesaro, Rusev, Roman Reigns, The Miz, Big Cass, Charlotte, Baron Corbin, Apollo Crews, Kalisto, Luke Gallows, Bubba Ray Dudley, Tyler Breeze, and Paige. On Team SmackDown, we have Kevin Owens, Brock Lesnar, John Cena, Sasha Banks, Samoa Joe, Bayley, Sami Zayn, Shinsuke Nakamura, Chad Gable, Asuka, Enzo Amore, Xavier Woods, Luke Harper, Chris Jericho, Jason Jordan, Carl Anderson, Neville, Scott Dawson, Becky Lynch, and The Undertaker. So that's the talents that have been taken so far. We're going into our third round of play, and I believe since Team Raw started last week, Team SmackDown will be starting this week.
Okay.
All right.
And this will be done between Matt Carlins and Mad Mike, by the way, representing Team SmackDown.
And Riz and Wheels will be representing Team Raw.
Yeah.
Sound like a golf announcer.
So Matt?
I'm going to let Mad Mike do the honors on the first pick because I got something special planned for that.
All right. With our first pick for the third round, Sorg, I don't know if you've noticed this about us, but we've been going for a bit more of an international flair. So we want the Pride of Mexico, Michael, Alberta Del Rio.
Yeah,
that's how JBL says it.
I can't believe you didn't do Ricardo. Okay.
Oh, no, I can't roll my R's.
Really? You can't do that?
No, I can't.
Not everyone can roll their R's, people.
Nope.
Yeah. Oh, you mean he can't do Alberto Del Rio?
No, we can't.
We can't do that. But he's ours now, motherfucker.
Okay.
He'll do it for us.
You say it like JBL from now.
Now I'm Michael Alberto Del Rio, Michael.
And he's facing Dolph. Anyways,
Ziggler with an L. Yes. With an L.
Anyways, with our first pick, and Wheels, do you want to go with that one?
Yeah, I totally agree with that one.
Okay. With our first pick of round three, Team Raw selects, by the way, I messed that up on the site. We select a double Austin Aries.
Damn it.
Okay.
That's a good one.
Yeah.
And let me update that because I put Team Raw instead of Team SmackDown.
Those are our two picks so far. Next pick goes to Team SmackDown.
Okay. With the 43rd overall pick in the Mayhem Draft.
Well,
hashtag Team Smack selects.
What?
Do it, Matt.
Okay. I don't want to.
Matt, do it.
No.
Do it.
Matt, if it's what you're saying, you can hold off. You're cool. I'm cool with holding off one.
No, I just want to get it over with.
I give you the permission.
Do it, just Matt. Say it.
Do it.
Dash Wilder.
Oh.
What? We secured the Revival.
Yeah. Oh, man. That's...
We got American Alpha and the Revival on our side.
Hey, hashtag fight forever.
Matt.
You know that fucking amazing match that happened at TakeOver? That's going to be happening a lot now on SmackDown.
Matt, your disgust about that pick?
Yes.
Is felt on this side.
You know, whatever.
I know you wanted a bad too.
Wheels?
Yes, sir.
Pull that trigger, sir.
All right. Our next pick on Team Raw, Braun Strowman.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Because we got a lot of the Wyatt family.
All righty.
Run.
All right, Matt, I think we're in agreement.
On I don't think you can go wrong with either one of those, so just do it.
Okay, well, guess what, guys? This is the Wrestling Mayhem Show draft, so you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to draft a friend of the Wrestling Mayhem Show. That's right, I want the bee's knees, the cat's pajamas, the whole fucking shebang, Johnny Wrestling, Johnny Gargano!
Okay, guys. I'm going to put this in the Slack. I want you guys to make sure that we are on the same page here.
You got it.
Where's my Slack? There it is.
We're all talking about Eva Marie.
Ew.
See that name?
Yes. Pull that trigger.
Well, Mr. Mad Mike, mm-hmm. We too have a friend of the Mayhem Show.
Oh, really?
Mm-hmm. He is none other than Eric Young.
Oh, does Eric Young count?
Ooh, I don't
count.
He's
not on the official roster page.
He's not on the roster page.
He's on NXT.
He was on one
episode of NXT.
Mm. He's not signed.
I don't think that counts.
Yeah, he's not signed.
That was not on the official list.
You know what, Riz? That's all right.
I got okay. A backup pick. This has to be a lot because he definitely is on the roster.
Yeah, I was thinking the same person. Sword.
Are we going? Who called Toronto?
And I'm going to go for this
replay in the Mayhem draft.
May I do it? There, Riz. May I say it?
Sure.
Bobby Roode.
Again, not on the roster page.
No, I'll accept that.
He is on the fucking page.
Why is he accepted?
He's done house shows.
What?
I mean,
I'm going to look this up because you guys are.
Again, not on the roster page.
Not on the roster page.
Hasn't officially had a match on TV yet.
Wait, we're doing it on that?
I'm doing it off the list that I included everyone on, Riz.
Yep.
This is bullshit.
you guys didn't prepare properly and look at your official list, apparently.
Do your homework.
Apparently, Bobby Roode debuted on NXT.
No, he has not. He had a match at the Download Festival. That was it.
And was also on...
You know who else was on there? Kota Ibushi. We're not going to draft him.
That was good, Mike. I'm sorry, that was funny.
You guys are just stacking the deck here.
I'm just being honest. This is bullshit. Just trying to play fair.
No, Sorg, he's hurt, so they can't allow him on there.
Wait, no. Some people who are hurt.
No.
He's on the list.
Who's on the list?
He's on the list.
What's in the box?
Tyson Kidd.
Yeah, Tyson Kidd counts.
Tyson's fine.
Yeah. Okay.
I mean, in actuality, we don't know if he's going to return to wrestling, but he's on the list.
Yeah, he's
on your list, so he counts.
He's on the list that everyone got set. Everyone got set the same list.
Shit list. Stupid fucking list.
We play fair here on the Mayhem Show Draft.
Welcome to the Mayhem Show. Teams are made.
Woo, that was funny.
All right, so Matt, I think we have a consensus.
Woo! Yeah, I think we definitely have a consensus. Hey,
on the list.
You know what? I'm in a tag team building kind of mood right now. I got my Dash Wilder. I feel like Johnny Wrestling needs a friend. So we're going to take Tommaso Ciampa.
Okay. Yeah, buddy. Woo! Best tag team division in the sport.
Well, it's up to you. Please consult your list.
We didn't get a list.
Yes, we did.
I did not see a list.
You're not looking then hard enough.
No, because I even found it, Riz.
Yeah, seriously.
Another way, okay, if not the list, if everyone that's on the roster page.
Oh. Okay. Mm-hmm. Go. Let me go back here.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm just not doing any like.
Yeah, you guys are just making audible grunts. Yeah. That doesn't really help. What's your goddamn pick?
Because we're being silent for a reason.
Well, can't have dead air. Someone's got to talk.
Because we are picking the very manly Simon Gotch.
Ooh.
Okay.
Okay. Eamon and Matt, what do you think about what I just put in there?
That's what she said.
I don't know what that is. Oh, I think I know what you mean.
Yeah.
I don't know.
No? Okay. It was worth a shot. I kind of like the one I said beforehand, though.
Let's be safe. Let's be safe and go with the second one you proposed out of those two. Is it what Bobby just said? Well, I don't.
Yeah, no, I don't think what Bobby said is actually real.
Okay. So
is he on the list?
We only talk about.
You just sit over there and you study your list. Okay. And we'll be up here handling our business. All right.
Oh, actually, I like what Bobby just said.
I like Bobby's too. Do it.
Yeah. All right. Okay, guys. Again.
Pull the trigger.
International flavor, motherfuckers. Guess who was injured that y'all forgot about, but SmackDown fucking remembers. We're going with
Team SmackDown. Don't forget
it, Tommy.
Mm-hmm.
Because he's gonna find out who fucking attacked him, and I guarantee that person is now going to be on SmackDown.
Get ready.
First of all,
go to sleep, Jesus.
First of all, your number four has already been taken by us.
What? Well, then good. It's hard to cross-reference all these lists. So there's a lot of lists.
But I think do you think we should just take the safe pick here? Because we got one.
We almost took your safe pick.
We got one.
Wait, what do we know?
They were talking about Aiden English.
Go ahead. Finish. Close the circle.
Let's get the vaudevillains. Aiden English, you're coming over.
Okay. Yeah.
So what number are we on?
We each have get five more picks.
Okay. But I will. Yeah.
Matt, if you can just take a look at what I put in there, I think
let's start with my war room real quick.
I think that's the way we should go next, Matt. I really think.
I feel like there's a place for that person on the card that we're dreaming up. You guys are working on your card already, right? You guys haven't been talking about your card. We've been talking about our card.
Good job for you guys.
Yeah, because we book long term.
Mm-hmm.
Just it's good.
Y'all are thinking Impact. We're thinking Lucha Underground. Boom.
That's right. That's right.
Yeah.
We're not actually going to have matches here.
No, we are.
Yeah,
no,
we are.
We're gonna make a card, man. Yeah. Gotta make it work within the confines of the thing.
Riz, did you not read the rules?
This game's fucking stupid.
Riz did not read any of the literature. All right, so Matt, you and I said that.
Yeah, I'm kind of waiting to see if Garza and Bobby are going to chime in on this idea here.
Because I think the other one mentioned, I think we can wait on that.
Okay.
Even if that rumor is accurate, which I don't think it is.
I don't think that's. I think that was some erroneous.
I do like your last pick there, Mike or Sorg.
Okay, right.
Let's just do it. We agree, Matt.
Let's just do it. It's you, it's me. You know, Garza can deal with it later on because we're going to take his favorite at one point anyways, probably higher than we need to anyways. We're gonna drop the bombshell right now, and we're going to take Nikki Bella.
Yeah! The longest reigning Divas champion in history, sons.
Strong-style Nikki.
Yeah. And plus, now we got the whole Bella clan. We got Nikki and John Cena, motherfuckers.
I feel intergender match coming on.
Riz, I think I ought to let you pull the trigger on the next one.
What is the next one? What do you want to do?
I say...
Do you want to go with him? Or do you want to go with her?
Her.
Her?
Yes.
Go ahead. Pull it.
All right. You know, what does the fox say?
Oh, I see what you did there. You're going Eva Marie. That's weird. That's a weird segue for
That was horrible.
I'm sorry.
You're actually going to say who it is?
Alicia Fox.
Yeah.
That was...
I'm sorry, Riz.
Wow.
I had to let it out. I'm sorry. I had to do it.
Okay.
All right. So
Riz, I think after I made that bad joke.
In the slack.
Yep.
Yeah. Bobby thought you
went off the list again.
I'm sorry, I went off the list again.
Matt, I'm okay with either the one you said or the first one Eamon said. Whatever you guys want to do.
And Bobby just got it. Okay.
Yeah, Bobby just got it.
Oh, I get it. Okay.
Yeah. Okay. I see your point, Matt. Amy, you good with the one Matt said?
Yeah, I'm fine.
All right.
That well, is the kind of reaction I wanted for that day. Total resignation, Heyman.
All right. Guys, you know what SmackDown needs? SmackDown needs movie stars. You guys got The Miz, and he's mm-hmm. been in a couple of direct-to-DVD films. But you know what? We are going to pick a guy who is in a legitimate summer blockbuster motherfucker. That's right, the Celtic Warrior, a.k.a. Rocksteady, Sheamus.
That's a value pick.
That's okay, fella.
Let's see. Let me see this thing here. I just want to check something out.
You check something out there.
I'm going to check this here.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay. I'm going to sneak in a name here. I'm just going to tell you guys. Ooh, maybe.
Mm-hmm.
But just throwing that name out there. But I do like your first pick, Sorg. Wow. So Wheels?
Yes, sir.
Are you ready for a revolution?
Yes, I am.
Are you ready for a Emma-lution?
Yes, I am.
Stupid fucking list.
I don't think either of you knows how her theme song goes.
No, I don't. I
That's what I was actually. You know what? No, now that you mentioned it, her theme song doesn't go anything like that anymore.
It doesn't do it anymore.
Now she has a new evil theme song.
Yeah, it slows it down and makes it more creepy, just like Undertale does. Moving on.
Is everybody good on this, man?
Yeah. I think
I get to make this pick because when letters no longer serve any purpose, you got to stick with some numbers. Boom, we're taking Ty Dillinger, baby.
10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10.
We might as well get at least one fan of the show, friend of the show.
Yeah,
one friend of the show.
Yeah,
so
no, it's one that's on the list.
Yes, yeah.
It is. Bitch, you stupid list. It is. Riz, yes,
he's a friend of the show, and he's probably friends with that that guy that's on Sorgatron Media, Sawtooth Willie. He's probably friends with him.
Ooh. That is a good one. By the way, check out Sawtooth Willie on Wrestling on Sorgatron Media.
Can't book Sawtooth Willie.
No, he's not. He's apparently not on the list.
No, but his friend is.
But his friend is, and it's the Drifter, Elias Sampson.
Yeah.
Okay.
That's solid.
Yeah. I like how we're in that mode of. Yeah, good.
Very much poker face mode right now. So.
All right, guys. I'm kind of feeling what Matt Collins was doing this last pick. He said,
"Well, we got two more
letters. We need numbers. So you know what? We're gonna go from 10, and we're gonna multiply that by 10 to get Andrade Cien Almas.
Bless you.
Booyah.
Booyah.
That's racist."
Who's racist about
it? I don't know. Yes, but Almas is ours.
All the moss is ours.
Yep.
Yeah?
Yes.
Do I get a consensus from Sorg? Yes? No? Maybe?
Yes.
Amen, I say we go my pick.
Wait, are you saying yes or are you saying why? Because I am not sure what that means, Sorg.
No. Okay.
Sorg is just typing why the entire time we're doing this. I don't know why we're doing this, Sorg. It's but he is on the list. So can we go with him, please?
He's on the list.
I'm okay with this.
Sorg, if you don't answer, somebody's going to get their wig split. We chose Mark Henry.
Okay.
Nice pick. That's a good pick.
Okay, so we got one final pick for Team SmackDown. No, Matt, I don't like your last one.
Oh, come on, man.
No, Matt, I
you
like
know what?
That.
You're right. You're right. That's Matt. Better. That's better saved for the first pick.
Yeah,
in the next
way, round. I was gonna say, Matt, yes, sir. Matt, last pick, last round for that
the
one.
Pick that last. The one I posted last.
Oh, no. I've already got okay. Mr. slash Mrs. Irrelevant already picked out yes. in my brain. You guys are going to have your minds blown. I'll tell you in the Slack after this is done.
All right. Okay.
So are we going with the one I think the one most people are suggesting?
I mean, I think
Bobby is suggesting different people. Come on, Bobby.
I think we should get both of them. I think we should get the one I said.
I haven't picked anything from Bobby yet.
Well, okay. The one Bobby last suggested.
Bobby is throwing out every name in the book.
Wait, right. No,
it's too funny. No, I love it. It's good.
Matt, the smaller of the two.
The smaller of the two?
Great tally. Good job. Good pick, guys.
We know we beat you right to it, Riz.
You know what? I don't feel like there's a wrong answer here. They're all like, they have their pluses and their minuses. So just try to find some sort of guy. Antonio's right there with me, though. I got to be honest. He's feeling me right now.
I'd say we get that person first pick next round. That's me. I'm okay with that.
No, I think we. And for
are you sure that person is going to make it past the end of this round, though? You got to be careful.
Absolutely positive. Absolutely positive. I know how these two motherfuckers thinking. They're not thinking that.
Two?
Yeah, you and Wheels.
I'm kind of siding with the bigger one, but it's okay. It's okay.
I'm happy either way.
I'm happy with either. I prefer the smaller one.
Perfect. That's what she said.
No,
she did not.
Nope.
No,
that's not.
No, you might have said that's you, Wheels.
None.
Oh,
never
said.
Wow.
I say we do it, Matt. I say we get the smaller one.
You know, Matt, it's up to you.
We'll leave it in your hands.
In my hands?
Between
is
those
it because,
between
because
those
I was two. The one who was forced to bear the shame of drafting Dash Wilder?
Whatever,
is that why I get the chance?
I told you I would draft Dash Wilder.
Listen, this is going to go on forever
Matt,
if you guys don't pick.
Matt, yes, it's sir. Up to you. Between those two.
Yeah, not the one Bobby just
and said. Only those two. No, the one. No,
the one
no,
Bobby
no.
said.
I know, I get it. The big one or the little one?
Either between
yes.
the bigger one or the little one.
I
it's up to
I'm
you.
I'm just thinking value and where we can maybe get the other one. God. I say go with the bigger one.
Go with it.
God damn it. Okay. Matt, you make
the pick. Are you picking or something?
Upside. Oh, let me do it?
Yeah, yeah.
Yes.
It's your pick. I did the last one.
We're going to take the big one. Nia Jax.
Ooh, okay.
Mm. And that will be your nickname going forward.
Honestly, that was one of the ones we were actually thinking back and forth on.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to have her come out our first show and be like, I'm not the bad one.
I'm not the small one. I'm not the medium one. I'm the big one.
I'm surprised he lasted this long. I mean, I'm double checking here, triple checking, quadruple checking.
I know who you're getting.
I think there's
a reason he's left.
There's a real good reason.
Yep.
Oh, damn.
So I'm just gonna say, you guys picked the movie stars too, right?
Mm-hmm.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. Good. Because you know,
I know what he's gonna say.
Oh God, you're not gonna go there, are you?
I know what he's gonna say.
We have Rusev. You know that, right?
Yeah.
Okay. You know what happened on? You know, there's a movie with Rusev in it.
Yes, sadly I do.
Mm-hmm. You know who else was in that movie?
Mm-hmm. Oh yeah, I know.
That's gotta be
Dolph Ziggler.
Oh. Okay. Carlos thought it was Kane.
Yeah, that's true. He was also in that movie.
Yeah,
he
was. Wait, honestly, I think we all forgot Dolph Ziggler existed.
Yeah, it's kind of weird.
And that wasn't even who I thought you were going to say.
Thank goodness.
Remember that match with Baron Corbin?
Hey, you guys.
Hey, you guys can have it on this show.
You can have them fight forever.
Oh, man. Okay, so that's a...
Fuck, that lasted forever.
But that's how we play the game.
Triple H?
I'm going to run to... Yes. I'm going to run through everyone's picks right now. Let's do this. Okay, so Team Raw consists of...
You guys picked Dash Wilder, for fuck's sake. Come on.
Forget the fucking tank.
Hey.
Don't you...
Ride or die with Dash Wilder, all right? Besides, once we had Scott Dawson, we had the choice.
No flips, just fists, Rince. Team Raw consists of Seth Rollins, Finn Balor, Kofi Kingston, Bray Wyatt, Dean Ambrose, Big E, AJ Styles, Cesaro, Rusev, Roman Reigns, The Miz, Big Cass, Charlotte, Baron Corbin, Apollo Crews, Kalisto, Luke Gallows, Bubba Ray Dudley, Tyler Breeze, Paige, Austin Aries, Braun Strowman, Tyson Kidd, Simon Gotch, Aiden English, Alicia Fox, Emma, Elias Sampson, Mark Henry, and Dolph Ziggler. Team SmackDown consists of Kevin Owens, Brock Lesnar, John Cena, Sasha Banks, Samoa Joe, Bayley, Sami Zayn, Shinsuke Nakamura, Chad Gable, Asuka, Enzo Amore, Xavier Woods, Luke Harper, Chris Jericho, Jason Jordan, Carl Anderson, Neville, Scott Dawson, Becky Lynch, The Undertaker, Alberto Del Rio, Dash Wilder, Johnny Gargano, Tommaso Ciampa, Hideo Itami, Nikki Bella, Sheamus, Ty Dillinger, Andrade Cien Almas, and Nia Jax.
Yeah.
So, yeah. Man,
I must say, both teams have some damn good talent.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. SmackDown has a lot more, though.
The roster be stacked.
So we have one more week of picking 10 picks.
Oh, thank God.
Jesus
Christ. I'm having fun, Riz. I'm sorry.
Wait, we're not going fun. Okay.
Riz better pay attention to his list. That's all I got to say.
Fucking list. My list.
but
it's all about the list and how you read it.
The best part, Riz, is that once we finish this, things aren't done after that, because as Mike has mentioned, we will be drafting a SummerSlam card, and SummerSlam's on the horizon, featuring our roster, and we're going to have more details on rules about that and stuff going forward. So yeah, that's how the Mayhem Draft is shaping up so far.
All right, and good stuff there. So with that, we'll end the show. And tell me, what did you learn from wrestling this week? Everybody go at once.
I learned that it's really weird to see stills from TNA on a WWE network.
Yes, absolutely.
Yeah, very odd.
Absolutely. The AJ Styles Stone Cold podcast. Yeah, I was amazed how deep they got into with TNA.
I wish they could have gotten deeper, but I thought it was a really fun and interesting listen. It was odd that he didn't talk that much about Dixie.
Well, for your thoughts on what he really thinks about Dixie Carter, you can check out AJ Styles' The Missing Matches, where we talked to him on DVD with Joe Dabrowski, that I happened to film. And what he thought about Impact Wrestling, maybe. He was still PC about it, but he got deeper into what he thought the problem with Impact was on there. So yeah, AJ Styles Missing Matches over on JoeDabrowski.com and IndieWrestling.us. So putting that out there. Matt Carlins, what did you learn from wrestling?
Oh, man. You know, it kind of stole my idea. I kind of learned that saying TNA on WWE programming is kind of like swearing in front of your parents, because, like, it's like the last thing Austin and AJ wanted to say. It's like they kept glancing over and saying, like, can we say this word that we're not supposed to say?
Because
I'm surprised they didn't bleep TNA and let them say fuck.
It's just like when you say it's just such a black hole. It's the one promotion. Like, how many promotions get their names dropped? on WWE programming now. Like New Japan and Ring of Honor, and they would just throw everything out. Like TNA is the one, like, no, 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 we don't talk about that. Crazy. Absolutely crazy.
Alrighty. Well, I guess I shall go next then. I'm going to say that I learned that you do not mess with Titus O'Neil's family.
Oh, God.
Because that man will go apeshit on you.
Yeah.
So you were wearing earplugs, weren't you? You were wearing your earphones.
What?
Sorg.
Okay. What?
Were you wearing your earphones during that segment?
The last? Yeah.
With Titus?
What?
With Titus?
Sorg is drunk.
What are you talking about?
Where he just yelled into the camera and almost like broke the sound.
Dude, he almost broke my speakers. I'm like, what the hell?
The microphone.
Maybe you guys have your TVs up too.
Yeah, I think I think you guys have.
The microphones were weird last night on Raw.
Yeah. Huh. Yeah, no, I didn't notice it. Now I'm watching the USA Now app feed to my Apple TV. So I don't know if that's different or not. So I don't know. What about you, Eamon?
Speaking of that, what I learned is also about Titus O'Neil. I learned from Money in the Bank that Titus O'Neil kisses his kids on the mouth. And I don't know how to feel about that.
Hey, that is my Twitter friend. You shut your mouth.
I am
followed by that man.
I've just not seen that before.
I do not want to get unfollowed because I am conversating with you.
I mean, he's a great dad, but
that great dad.
Just haven't seen that.
Some would argue he's the mega dad of the year.
Yeah,
dad is so dad. That's okay. So I learned going back to the AJ thing. I learned that all around the world means 1990s air styles. Clips from WCW.
I thought you were going into a song cue.
So did
people
I.
People stop and they watch. Yeah.
All around the world,
statues crumble for me.
Yeah, thank you, Wills.
We're gonna get sued by those guys.
And we just got our live feed taken off by
please,
YouTube.
They don't even exist anymore.
Sugar Ray? No, wait, no, that's
yeah, exactly my no, point. That's not even right there.
Did the Sugar Ray die or something?
It's Sugar Ray. I'm thinking Smash Mouth.
Yeah, you are. Bobby from the chat room also learned that he had friends over from.
Wait, Smash Mouth? Smash Mouth is dead?
Sure. No. Smash Mouth will never die.
Okay.
No, they're walking on the sun. Bobby learned that he had friends over for Money in the Bank, and his friend Josh, who doesn't watch wrestling, came for Game of Thrones afterwards, but caught the last match, and he said it was pretty cool. So I guess Bobby learned it was a damn good pay-per-view.
Yay.
And also, Baron Corbin needs to lose a casket match to get his black pants back. Points.
Somebody wore the brown pants.
Nice.
thanks, Sorg.
Hey-o. Yeah.
Sorg.
Yes.
Yeah. What did you
learn? I learned damn tag team wrestling. I'm really excited about what I saw just even on Sunday night. We had three tag team matches that night.
Yeah,
two were on the kickoff show, but holy crap, you know, having the Dudleys in the mix, even just a fun thing like we talked about on the kickoff show with a Golden Truth and the sunburn angle. I'm really excited for the angle to see that it's still strong. I know I feel like we say this every 6 months.
But,
yeah, exactly. And so that's strong. And so I'm not worried too much about that, you know, being split up. As far as the draft goes. So that's what I got. Guys, I think everybody went. Thank you so much. Wrestling Mayhem Show, WrestlingMayhemShow.com. Drop us a line, 412-206-WMS0. Good times.
Good times.
Good times. Good times at WrestlingMayhemShow.com. You want a shirt like I'm wearing tonight on the show? Go over ProWrestlingTees.com/WMS or our shop linked over on Spreadshirt for many of our designs, including some by our good friend Alex Carrs of Occupy Pro Wrestling. And thank you so much, everybody, for joining us. And subscribe, like, all that kind of stuff. Share it. Thank you to our friends, The Riz. Riz Plays Games. Mm-hmm. Hot Wheels RWA on the Twitters. And RWALive.com for information on the next time they'll be around. And, of course, Eamon Payton, the voice of Inspire Pro Wrestling. The only wrestling in Texas worth checking out.
Sure.
Matt Collins Mainstream Matt on the Twitters around the indies. His column over at indiewrestling.us.
Check it out tomorrow.
There you go. And of course, Mad Mike up in Poughkeepsie, New York. The only one here.
Check out the live tweet.
The live tweets in the midweek war, and the only one here future endeavored by the WWE.
Oh yeah. Hashtag MM for the live tweet tonight. Mm-hmm. Boom.
Thank you so much, everybody. Sorgatron on the Twitters, hit me up. See you guys next time. Thank you to our chat room, live.sorgatronmedia.com, live.wrestlingmayhemshow.com. We get kicked off here about 8 p.m. with the wrestling talk, and we go way longer than we probably should. We'll see you guys next time. Mayhem out. Wait, just wait. This show is a member of the Sorgatron Media Podcast Network. Find out more at sorgatronmedia.com. Guys are cool.